Hey everybody, today we're going to be talking about broad match keywords in Google Ads. This is your start to finish guide to using broad match in your Google Ads campaign. A lot of people say that this match type is a waste of money, and this is the way that Google wastes all of your money in Google Ads. And I'm going to show you a campaign that actually shows better results in the broad match than it does in the phrase and exact. My name's Adam, I'm the owner of Paracore. We're a pay-per-click lead generation agency in Phoenix, Arizona. This is what we do. We talk about pay-per-click in this channel. Covers all things pay-per-click as well. Today we're talking about Google Ads broad match. If you've watched many of my videos, you will know that I like to show the Google Ads documentation because they have really good illustrations of how different things work, and also to show you how you can learn more if you're trying to do some research yourself and you don't want to be looking up YouTube videos. But look up my YouTube videos, just don't look up everybody else's. All right, so here we're looking at broad match. I really like this diagram because it shows the different types of matching: broad match, phrase match, and exact match. And if you look at the blue boxes here, you'll see that broad match extends out here, which means it's more broad and captures more searches. Phrase match captures less than broad, it's inside this box, but more than exact. And then exact is the most narrow. There used to be a match type called modified broad that you might see in accounts, which has been blended with phrase match. Modified broad has plus signs. So if you ever see plus signs with keywords, that's modified broad. It is being deprecated by Google. Basically what they're saying is if you see it in an ad account, I'm actually going to show you an ad account that has it in another video when we do phrase match. But if you see it in an ad account, it's basically going to act like phrase match. So it doesn't break anything, but anyways, too far off track for this video. We're talking about broad match today. So broad match. Broad match is the most broad keyword type available in Google Ads. And I'm going to show you what it looks like in the ads account. I'm going to show you how to add it as well. And what it's saying is ads may show searches that are related to your keyword, which can include searches that don't contain the content, the keyword terms. This means that they take a lot of liberties. They help attract more visitors, spend less time. They say you can spend less time building keyword lists and focus your spending on keywords that work. It's the default, which means that it's going to be the one that if you just type in the keyword, that's what they're going to use. And the syntax for broad match is putting the keyword, nothing around it. For phrase match, you put in quotes. And for exact match, you put in brackets. So as an example, this broad match keyword, low carb diet plan, is basically saying, what Google's telling you here is ads may show on searches for, and you probably can't read this because I can't really read it, carb-free foods. So if your keyword is low carb diet plan and someone searches for carb-free foods, your ad might show. Carb-free foods and low carb diet plan, sort of related, but not really related. Low carb diets. If someone's looking for a diet and you have low carb diet plan, those are similar. Low calorie recipes. Now, if you're looking for a recipe, now if someone's looking for a recipe and they see your diet plan, close, but really not the same intent. A diet plan is different than a recipe. Mediterranean diet books, that's very different. And low carbohydrate dietary programs. So that one's pretty similar. Basically what Google's saying is that they're taking a lot of liberties with these broad match keywords. And I'm gonna show you how broad they can be in this ad account here in a minute. So to help deliver matching results, they take into account the user's recent search activities to understand their intent, the content of the landing page, and then other keywords in an ad group to understand, again, the keyword intent, the search intent, the consumer's intent. So let's look at an ad account real quick that uses broad match. So this is an ad account that we have running here. It's a small window and door campaign, but we're gonna be looking at a Windows campaign. And what you'll see here is we have three different ad groups, window installation, new windows, window companies. We've spent about $2,700. This is over 30 days. A couple hundred clicks, $4 a click, 36 conversions. Cost per conversion is $76. So when I click into this ad group, we see window installation is the only keyword, and it's a broad match keyword. And in order to create a broad match keyword, you jump in here, you type in window installation. I'm not gonna click save because we already have it, but that's it. You just type in the word. If you wanted to do phrase, you would do phrase like this, which we're not talking about today. And then if you want to do exact, you would do exact like this, which we're also not talking about today, but I wanted to show you what they look like. If you wanted to do broad match and then you also wanted to do phrase, you can do two, you can add two keywords at the same time like this. And then you can do the same thing with exact. But right now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna, I'm gonna hit cancel here because I don't wanna add the new keyword, but that's how you add it. So you can see keyword, no notations around it, no phrases or brackets. 198 clicks, 2.5% click-through rate, average cost per click of $5. Now what I wanna show you is A, I wanna show you the cost per conversion, which I'm just gonna go back here because it's, I'm gonna change the columns. So right here, we've spent about $1,000 in each of these roughly. And the cost per lead is $90 here, $55 here, and $96 here. I'm actually gonna go to this one. It has more search terms in it. It has more conversions in it. So new windows, same thing, new windows. Over here on the left, I'm gonna go to search terms. And what we see, I'm sorting by clicks here. What we're seeing is that this keyword is triggering searches. When these searches take place. So someone typed in awning windows and it triggered our keyword new windows. Remember, our keyword is new windows. So someone typed in Google awning windows and it triggered our ad and three people clicked it out of 9 impressions. Black windows, not really the same as new windows. Fiberglass windows, not really the same as new windows. Affordable windows plus exteriors, low E windows costs, you know. So these are broad. They're basically companies, they're types of windows. No one's really saying new windows. Now, wholesale windows, that's kind of implying that they're looking for new windows. Approximate cost of new windows. Now, what I'm also gonna look at over here is conversions. So here I'm sorting by clicks. I'm gonna sort by conversions now. And this is what I like is that, this is what I like with broad match is that you get conversions on keywords that you never would have thought of yourself. So universal window, that's probably a competitor, although I haven't searched it, but I'm guessing that's a competitor, or maybe it's a type of window like universal, I don't know. But I never would have put that in a keyword, like as a phrase match or an exact match. Approximate cost of new windows, that makes sense, but you know, it has new windows in it, but cost of new windows, maybe, yeah. 96 by 36 window, no possible way would I put that in as a keyword. A frame windows cost, no. I mean, like maybe window cost, but a frame windows cost, I don't even know what that means. Fiberglass windows, that's very generic. Sunroom windows, they're basically just saying like, I want these windows. Tinted replacement windows, windows wholesale. So, you know, you can see here that people are searching for really interesting things and they're converting, right? So out of the, this is one thing I hate about Google is it only shows you 9 of the conversions. There's 74 other clicks and 7 other conversions that we're not even seeing. But you can see here that our cost per conversion is $55, which is crazy. So even when I look at the clicks and I look at like this quote unquote wasted spend, like when I negative this out, I mean, I probably wouldn't negative this out just because I don't like these could very well convert because it's people just like looking for the windows. Now there are some types of searches that I may add negatives to, which are just super irrelevant. I'm trying to see what they would be. I mean, the reality is like these all look irrelevant, but our cost per lead is pretty solid. And I'm gonna show you, so this is this campaign here, which is broad match. And then I'm gonna jump over to this other campaign, which is, this campaign is not broad match. This uses phrase and exact match. And you'll see here, this is window installation. I just pause the video for a second. So this one's window installation, same concept, but it's kind of more geographically located, like window replacement near me, window company Scottsdale, Mesa. This one is more broad. It doesn't have any of the near me stuff. So our cost per lead here is $76, cost per conversion over the last 30 days. And our cost per conversion here is $100. This is a little bit longer. This is a couple months. So let me just do last 30. Is $123. So these are much more narrow, much more specific, new windows, they're geographically located, and you would think they're higher intent, but this broad one is actually doing much better. And my guess is that one of the reasons is because when, you know, these search terms that are converting, like nobody's buying these search terms, like nobody's buying 96 by 36 windows as a search term, right? Like this is just triggering in a broad. So while this seems to not make any sense, and a lot of these don't seem to make any sense, nobody else is buying these. That's being really specific with their searches. So these are doing quite well. So this campaign's doing well. So that pretty much covers it for broad match. We have started using these a lot more. You do have to take a kind of particular approach to your negatives, but I would recommend not diving too deep on negatives. I've actually seen this converting better in many accounts than my phrase and exact match campaigns. So those are broad match keywords. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If this was helpful, you like the channel, please like, subscribe, and again, hit me up with a comment. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video.